I'ma show you that where you from. No matter to me. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, mara. Then she said, sabase.
Hi loves, welcome back to my channel. Before we get started in the video, I just want to make sure you guys are following me on my Instagram. That's __A_Marie with 5 E's at the end. Without further ado, let's get started on how to lay that wig. So let's just hop right into it. So right now I'm just showing you guys how much leave out I have, which is a little bit. It's just pretty much the front of my hair. Just enough to kind of cover up the sides and the front part of the wig. So I just wanted to show you guys how much I have out. Okay, so the first step is creating a straight part. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just kind of creating a part with the little baby hairs that I have in the front. You want to try to make it as straight as possible. You kind of want to align it with the part that's in the wig, or wherever your part is at. You kind of just want to make sure that it kind of aligns with your real part in your hair. So that's what I'm doing right now. It kind of takes me a while because I'm trying to get that super, 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 super straight part. But it's like I'm dealing with baby hairs. You know, baby hairs kind of just have a mind of their own. So right now, just creating that part. It looks to be straight. So then we're going to go ahead and move on to gluing. I'm using a lace bond glue that I had got from my local beauty supply store. However, I did not like, that was my first time actually using that lace glue and I didn't like it. I would actually suggest using Walker Tape Ultra Hold. I'll leave everything that I use down below. But basically, I'll just use the end of my rat tooth comb, dip it in the glue, and then kind of just place it right at the front of the wig. I'm just going to press that down, and then I use a blow dryer to kind of like make the glue dry a lot faster, and so that it sticks. And so I'll basically just blow dry it for about, I would say, a couple minutes, like, you know, 2 to 4 minutes, maybe not 4 minutes, that's a little excessive, maybe like 2 to 3 minutes. And so once I feel like it's tacky enough, then I'll go ahead and stop. But so I'll just blow dry it until I feel it's tacky. And then right now I'm just kind of cleaning it up. Sometimes the glue kind of gets all over the place. The glue is very, 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 very sticky. So just make sure you guys are careful when dealing with that. So right now I'm using my Anastasia concealer and my Sigma brush. And the concealer name, I want to say it's Nude. Yeah, it's Nude. It's the Anastasia Contour Cream Kit. But you can use whatever concealer that you typically use for your face. You can use that for your hair. And so I'll kind of just put the concealer on the top of the wig just to give it more of like a natural look and to kind of match it with my skin color. So I'm going to, after I finish applying the concealer on the wig part, I just like to buff it out just because, I just try to make it as natural, and sometimes parts are not that obvious. So I do buff it out to kind of make it a more natural, smoother look. And I'll kind of bring that to the front. And then those baby hairs. Then right now I'm just going to go in with a smudge brush and then my black eyeshadow from MAC. I cannot remember the name, but honestly you can just use whatever dark or whatever black eyeshadow that you have or whatever color your hair is. Use that. And what I'll do is I'll just go in and kind of clean up. There's a lot of cleanup when it comes to this whole wig process. So I kind of just want to go in and clean that up and kind of fill in any places that I feel like needs more of like more hair, I guess, because it kind of, when you apply the black eyeshadow, it kind of acts as a hair filler. So wherever I feel like could use more of a fuller look, or I feel like needs to be more hair here or whatever, then I'll just go ahead and like fill that in. pretty much is what I do. So to lay the baby hairs, I don't know why I'm like showing it in the camera. The name is completely scratched off. But I'm using Vonte. I don't know if you guys remember Vonte from like way back in the day, like early 2000s when like everybody was on Vonte. And then I think it like they stopped selling it or something like that. I don't even know what happened. But then one of my friends actually, I guess, goes to the supplier and like buys it from him personally. I guess it's hard to get. I'm not sure. But that's what I'm using on my edges. But you can pretty much use whatever edge control that you like. Yeah, so I'm just cleaning that up, making sure that my baby hairs are laid. Because you can't have a laid look, a laid wig, if your edges ain't laid. You feel me? So, so I'm just brushing my little baby hairs down. And yeah. I like to kind of wear my hair behind my ear. I don't know, it's just my thing. And then I'm using a hairspray. It's actually from John Frieda. It's the Caraflex Flexible Hold Hairspray. And what I do is I'll go ahead and spray the top of my wig because there's like little baby hairs at the top that kind of stick up. And I want to try to make the top of my head as flat as possible. So I'll spray the top of the head with hairspray and then I'll take my wand. I got this wand, I think, from Target for like 20 bucks. And I'll go ahead and press that down super hard so that the hair lays really, really flat. Because, you know, typically with wigs, the top of the head can be kind of like a little bulky. So I want to get it as flat as possible. So, I mean, this is the technique that I use that I feel like makes my hair super flat at the top. So yeah, I'm just sharing with you guys. I know a lot of people have asked me, like, how do I get it flat? So these are the steps that I take to get it super flat. So this is the finished look on how I achieve that super flat, natural look when wearing wigs. I really hope you guys found this video helpful and you guys enjoyed it. Please leave any questions down below. And don't forget to like and thumbs up, and I'll see you next time.